वेलकम बैक फ्रेंड्स. सो टुडे वी विल बी डीलिंग अबाउट द पार्ट 12 ऑफ अवर करंट रिवीजन, राइट, फॉर द यूपीएससी प्रीलिम्स. सो टुडे इन दिस क्लास वी विल सी अबाउट द एक्ट्स, डिफरेंट लॉज एंड द रेगुलेटरी बॉडीज रिगार्डिंग द एनवायरमेंट एंड इकोलॉजी. ओके, लेट अस गो अहेड एंड सी वन बाय वन. सो फॉर द कंटेंट फॉर द डे इज लाइक वी विल बी लुकिंग अबाउट द इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ द जीएम क्रॉप्स. What are the rules of with respect to the Environment Protection Act, Seed Act, and Cotton Act, right? So later we will look at the EPC, that is Environment Pollution Prevention and Control Authority. We already seen about this like in our previous classes, right? So later we will look at the National Green Tribunal and what is its origin and what is its significance, right? We'll also see about the CAMPA, that is Compensatory Afforestation Fund Management and Planning Authority. And how this fund is used by different states, right? Later we will look at the Central Groundwater Authority, use of methanol to reduce the greenhouse gases, Indian Forest Act amendment, and recent what is the issue regarding the same. There is a protocol to assess this snow leopard population. We will also look into that. And last two topics are Extended Producer Responsibility Scheme and NTCA, that is the National Tiger Conservation Authority, right? So let us go ahead. The first topic is Rules of Environment Protection Act 1986, Seed Act and Cotton Act, right? So what happened is, recently we have seen, we already discussed about this, that is the herbicide tolerant BT cotton has been illegally used by the different farmers in the Maharashtra. So this is the area of concern because this is not at all approved by the government, right? However, this we have seen the cases where this has been illegal distributed and been used. So in this context, they say that under these acts, this is illegal, right? So and also these are unapproved. See, the sale of the unapproved seeds can attract the action under these two acts. Okay. So the next topic is about the EPCA. We already discussed this earlier. So once again, we will look at this. So Environment Pollution Prevention Control Authority. So this has its origin from the Supreme Court judgment, right? So because of the heights of the air population that has reached in the Delhi, right? So this is a notified and in 1998 and then under the Ministry, Environment Ministry, right? So under the Act of Environment Protection Act 1986. So it's, what is its objective? Its objective is protecting and improving the quality of environment and controlling the environment pollution in the area of NCR, right? So we already seen the last current affairs regarding the same is like it has declared the public health emergency in the Delhi area, right? So main context, if such an emergency declared, so what are the actions that that you suggest? Might be that there might be such kind of question. So in that particular session, you can give a phased manner directions. Like first, we can say that apart from the government policies like the even out scheme, we need to first shut down the category of red industries like the thermal power industries, which generate high amount of pollution. Later, other industries, right? So next topic is about the National Green Tribunal. So this act, this tribunal has been established under the Act, National Tribunal Green Tribunal Act 2010. So this, it relates to the environment protection and conservation of forests. So including the enforcement of any legal act regarding the environment. Okay. So the important thing is like this is not restricted or does not follow the code of conduct of the civil code procedure, right? And it is given guided by the principles of natural justice, sustainable development, right? So similar kind of principles, and it is mandated to clear the particular filing within the 6 months. Okay, so its chairperson is appointed by the central government in consultation with the Chief Justice of India. So here the extended information regarding the same deals with the 7 laws. Okay. So regarding the environment, what are they? Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1974, another act, that is the Water Cess Act, later the Forest Act 1980, Air Pollution Act 1981, Environment Protection Act 1986, Public Liability Insurance Act 1991, Biological Diversity Act 2002, right? So the next topic is about the CAMPA, that is the Compensatory Afforestation Fund Management and Planning Authority. Good. This is also very much important in the context of mains, right? So this is in news because the recently central government has released nearly 50,000 crores to different states. Okay, so what exactly is this fund, compensatory afforestation fund, will be collected by the polluting the industries. Okay, so whatever the polluting industries, a part of certain kind of tax are made on those kind of industries, and entire fund goes to this compensatory afforestation fund. So this fund now has been given to different states almost like after a decade. So this is one of the issue because of the delay in the distribution. So so this fund is given as per the provisions of CAAF Act. Okay, so this is a statutory authority. So this has this body's inception has been in 2000 when the Supreme Court has ordered for such kind of body. So later, because this act has been passed by the government in 2016 and notified in 2018. So according to these rules, so this distribution of the fund goes like this, like the 90% will be given to the states while the 10% is retained by the center, and this fund is utilized for the afforestation processes. Okay, so we have another kind of fund that is called the District Mineral Foundation Fund. Okay, so please look into this. So this comes under the Ministry of Mines, this is used in those particular districts. Okay, so please Google little bit information regarding the same. Okay, the next topic is about Central Groundwater Authority. So this authority has been constituted under the Environment Protection Act 1986. Okay, and this deals with the regulation and control of groundwater development and its management. Okay, so why it is in news? Recently, this body has given no objection certificate for groundwater extraction in 23 states and union territories. So in this context, please look at the previous information that we have discussed, that about the heavy metals from the groundwater and how it is impacting the human health. For example, the fluorosis issues in the Nalgonda district of Telangana, and the arsenic heavy metal and the associated diseases in the eastern region of our country, like the West Bengal, right? So the next topic is about the use of methanol to reduce the greenhouse gas emissions. So we already seen this. So recently government has notified that you can use the M15 or M100, otherwise called as M100 and M95. So what is M15? It stands for 15% methanol blend. Okay, and the remaining 85% is the gasoline, that is nothing but the petrol, right? So please do not confuse that the 100 here stands for 100%. So practically 100% methanol is impossible to run an engine. According to BS4, if it is used, it reduces the greenhouse emissions by 5 to 10%. Okay, we already discussed about the four generations, right, of the alternate 4G fuels under the national biofuel policy, right? Please look into that, and the alternative fuels also, like the hydrogen. Okay, the next topic is about the Indian Forest Act amendment. So this has been news because the Mizoram government has rejected the central government proposed amendment to the Indian Forest Act 1927. Why it has rejected? It is saying that this is contravening to the 371G of the Constitution. What does it say? So it says that it cannot decide on the matters relating to the religious and social practices of Mizoram. Okay, so what happened is, like, because here the forest subject is intervened with the cultural daily life of the Mizoram people. So any change in this act is like changing in those cultural aspects as well, so which is like contravening to 371G of the Indian Constitution, as the Mizoram government says, right? So in this state, they have the present act called as Mizoram Forest Act 1955 that governs the state for forests in line with their customary laws. Okay, the next topic is about the protocol to assess the snow leopard population. So Union government for the first time has released this, the snow leopard population assessment. So at the fourth steering committee meeting of the Global Snow Leopard and Forest Ecosystem Program. Okay. So this assessment has been prepared by whom? While Wildlife Institute of India. This comes under the Forest Department, Nature Conservation Foundation, GSLEP. Here we have seen this, right? And the Global Tiger Initiative Council, WWF, World Bank, Global Tiger Forum, and Wildlife Conservation Trust. Okay. So extra information regarding this snow leopards. So this is vulnerable under IUCN. It covered under the Schedule 1 of the Wildlife Protection Act. Appendix 1 of the sites, right? And apart from this, there are other programs that cover the snow leopard. These are Project Snow Leopard, okay, one. And this other one is like Secure Himalayas. So this is the initiative of GEF along with the UNDP, okay. So what does it do? Generally aims at the conservation of high altitude biodiversity. Okay, so in this high altitude biodiversity, it also covers the snow leopard. Okay, the next topic is about extended producer responsibility scheme. So this was introduced in the plastic waste management 2011 rules, right? So we have already seen about solid waste management, what kind of solid waste management. Okay, please refer to those topics. So it covers the producers, importers, brand owners asked to take the primary responsibility for the collection of the used multi-layered plastic sachets or packings, right? So next and the final topic is about the National Tiger Conservation Authority. So this is a statutory body. This comes under the Ministry of Environment and Climate Change, and this is constituted under the Wildlife Protection Act 1972, and it has been amended in 2006. Okay, why? What is the need for such authority for the strengthening of the tiger conservation as per the powers and functioning according to given act? Okay, and I think there is a little confusion earlier. So its chairman is MoEF, that is the Ministry of Environment and Climate Change. Okay, not Prime Minister. And while Prime Minister is the head of National Board for Wildlife. National Board for Wildlife. So what is the significance of National Board for Wildlife? No alterations of boundaries in national parks or wildlife sanctuaries can be done without the approval of this board. Okay, so this is very much important. So please do share your feedback to improve our program. Okay, and all the best with your preparation. So let us see the content for the next class. Okay, till then, take care.